Congress from Souls Harbor Tabernacle in Gastonia. We're so glad to have you with us tonight. Those that are streaming, we're so glad to have you with us. Pray that you'll text in, let us know where you're from, and give your prayer request to Donnie, and we'll certainly pray over them at the end. Also, we appreciate those that are here. We thank you for coming. Not a big crowd here, but it's the day after Christmas. Some folks still out of town with their families and stuff. But it's so good to have you that made it, and those that chose to be here tonight. We're so proud to have you with us. Wish you a happy new year, and make it known to you that we're going to have a new year service Friday night. We'll have a new year service with two services. The Southland Singers will be here, and I'm not sure if they're going to stay for the second service, but some of them I think are, some of them's out of town again, like other people have that situation, but pray for them, and hopefully they'll be here. I know they're going to be here as far as I know at 7 o'clock and be singing with us as much as they can. Brother Eric's going to preach in the first service, Brother Chuck in the second service. We're looking forward to that, and we're going to have some kind of food in between. We hadn't narrowed it down exactly, but they're working on it. If you're a lady and you can help, we don't really need you to bring anything at this point. They might, but I feel like we can handle the cost of it. We just need some volunteers to help. If you're here, to let Betty know that you would help with that. We got a lot of ladies in the church sick. Sister Marcia is undergoing a lot of pain with the accident she had. We got her on the prayer list. So pray for her tonight. Pray for John, who's been sick. Pray for all the unspoken requests. We know God can deliver. Pray for Toddie Weaver. She continues her cancer treatment. I believe tomorrow's the day that she starts back for another round. Pray for Chuck and Joyce Poole in their church. Pray for Wendell Weaver. He's doing much better, and we're praying for him. My sister Louise in the hospital, and she blood pressure bottomed out, or didn't bottom out, but it got real low, 70 over 40, something like that, and she's in the hospital, so be praying for her. And at last I heard this morning, they're going to keep her a couple of days for observation, so just be praying for her. Geraldine's doing better, keep praying for her. And keep praying for my sister, Betty. Carolyn, they're not able to come at night, but they love the service, and they love the word, and they love the singing, so we just, they was to be listening, we dedicate the service to them tonight, praying for them. Several people we hadn't heard from, but those that are here, some of those, these names are here. Annie Hambright, keep praying for her. Colleen Woody, Dee Dee Woody, Kay and Kaylee Eason, Brother Peter Homovich, Mike Gilley, Lisa and Jeannie, Joyce's sister Gail, Brother Ralph and Sister Shirley, keep praying for them. Roy and Kat, keep praying for them. Good to see them tonight. Debbie West and Sister Sue, and Peggy Bridges' family, Charles and Lois Clark, Debbie Brooks and her family, Donnie and Francis Staple. And we're just believing God for all these. Pray for all the bereaved families, that God would minister to them and touch. I've just heard this week about several, a lot of them I don't even know, but on the news, and it's just heartbreaking, people in accidents and different things, and here at Christmas, and We're just so glad that God's still been good to us, amen, and to you. And even if you're going through a trial, he's been good to you. Unspoken request, that God see you in. Everybody have one tonight, amen. All right. Keep praying. I had it down here at the bottom, but I forgot to say it, but Rhonda's and Harvey's great-grandbaby's been sick. And
Just the grandbaby.
Okay, I thought it was there. Okay. And you're right, grandbaby.
The great's
not
here yet.
Okay. All right. Okay, grandbaby. Well, they, you know, my son Brad, one time, Mom was talking about one of Jimmy's grandbabies, and she said, he's my great-grandbaby. And Brad was this little boy. He said, he ain't no grander than I am, no greater than I am. So all grandbabies feel precious and special. And we, but they have a grandbaby that's a new baby that's going through some breathing situations and stuff. You can pray for that. Starting to hear anybody I want to speak. Anybody? Good to see Brother Sister Wilson. Had an anniversary this week, 71 years. Is that right? 71 years. Amen. I mean, I mess up on babies and grandbabies. I'll mess up on anniversary days. I'm going to mess up on mine. I'll be pretty good shape. Amen. And Sister Marcia.
I'm glad to be here. lady be much of prayer for Faith. She is very sick. She's got a terrible sore throat. She has been just so sick for the last couple of days. And St. Julie's going to try to get her to the doctor tomorrow. I don't know if she's got the flu or what, but just please pray for her.
Pray for that. Anybody else in the middle? Amen. What about over here on the left? Anybody, Sister Rhonda?
Speaking of the grandbaby, thanks for all of the prayers. She came home yesterday. She is, she's got 21 days that she's supposed to kind of be quarantined to keep from her spreading it to anybody else, mostly to little children or to elderly or immune-compromised people. But she still had a little bit of breathing problems, and they said she may come up to another month. So at 7 weeks old, that's a long time. That's almost half of what she's been alive. But thanks for your prayers and everything.
Amen. Amen.
Pray for Charlie and Tim and their family. They're going to be driving back from Detroit next couple of days. And they went up there to be with their family at the last minute. And so be praying for them. Brother Tony, come on and lead us in prayer, whatever the Lord would have you to do at this time. Praise the Lord. Amen. Worship with us tonight. Amen.
Stand your feet. We'll give the Lord in prayer tonight. Just thank the Lord for another opportunity to be in the house. Pray for this service tonight, Lord. You just reach down and touch everybody in it, Jesus. Touch lives, be blessed, Jesus. Pray for all these spoken requests tonight, Lord God. You minister to each and every one of them, Lord God. You can heal the sick, Lord God. Uplift them, Lord. Touch their bodies, Jesus. The ones missing tonight, Lord God. Know where they're at, Lord. Uplift them and comfort them, Jesus. The ones that's traveling over the holidays, Lord, you give them protection. Watch over them. Bring them back safely, Lord. We thank you for watching over the ones, Lord God, that have some problems, Lord God, so you can heal them and deliver them, Jesus. Pray for the service tonight, to the Lord, to send it, Lord, to preach it, Lord God. Lord, our ears to receive what's brought forth, Lord. We give you praise and glory and thanks, Jesus. In your name we pray, Lord. Amen. And you can turn page 394 to be on the board.
Dear Lord, what would I do? The angel beckoned. Come on.
And how many nights?
more time, just how much he loves me.
Amen.
Yeah. You know, when them two trucks was trying to make a sandwich out of me, glass was flying all around me. I was sitting in glass, it was in my lap. It was all around me. And not one piece of glass went in my shoes or anywhere. I told Betty I found one little piece down the sleeve of my sweater, and I just shook it out. But didn't have any cuts, no scrapes or nothing. You know, God just protected me, you know. And Hannah, the first thing she said, Mama, I was scared to death. I was going to come here, your face was going to be all cut up. But nothing touched me, not one scratch
Amen.
On my body.
Amen.
And I thank God he showed me just how much he loved me. He took care of me when things are so bad. You just trust God and he'll take care of you. My preacher said the devil tried to steal our peace. But I've retained my peace that God gave me, that peace he talked about last Sunday. And I was in such a good mood, and I felt so good when I was on my way to work. And then, you know, it just happened. But God took care of me one more time. He showed me just how much he loved me.
Yes.
Christmas, but it's all about Mama. I had a praise, Mama. How sweet and happy seem those days of which I dream, when memory recalls them now and then. And with that rapture sweet, my weary heart would be if I could hear my mother pray. I could only hear my mother pray again. If I could only hear her tender voice as then, so happy I would be, would mean so much to me. If I could hear my mother pray again. In the old home place, her face and smiling face, always pretty comfort, hope, and cheer. And when she used to sing sweet praises to her King, was the songs the angels loved to hear. If I could only hear my mother pray again, if I could only hear her tender voice as then, so happy I would be. I could hear my mother praying. Her work on earth is done, the crown of life she won, and she will be at rest with him above. And some glad morning she, I know, will welcome me to that eternal home of peace and love. I can only hear my mother pray again. I can only hear her tender voice again. So happy I would be, would mean so much to me. I could hear my mother pray again. I could hear my mother pray.
Those days when I wasn't walking with the Lord, she prayed for me, and the Lord didn't take me out. Y'all heard this testimony before. He could have took me out many times, but I think because of my mama's prayers and my daddy's prayers, that he had a plan for me. And I thank the Lord for praying mamas.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Anyone else have a song or testimony?
I was thinking, we were talking about my grandma yesterday. We sat at the house and was talking about her. But there's one thing she wasn't ever scared to do. If you told her you wasn't feeling good, she'd lay hands on you and pray for you. Right then, I don't care what it was, a stomach virus or a deathly disease, she'd lay her hands and pray for you right then. And she believed that God would heal you right then, too.
Amen.
And missed those prayers for probably more than I miss her. But Janice used to sing this song, and I just started singing it today. So.
Messengers in heaven, serve my life. Saint us by Jesus over my family. Jesus over my children.
Yeah.
Jesus over my husband, my wife, my church. Everybody that I can think about praying for you. I'm just waking up and asking God to please watch over and protect us. During the night, there is a lot of evil that takes place.
Yes.
Most of the time, it's a devil under the cover, and I guess because you can't see what's out there. Sometimes we just fear the unknown, but God's angels are always around us.
Amen.
Sometimes I know I'll put mine on overtime.
Amen.
So I will sleep sometimes.
Amen.
But God's angels are just there. And you know, day and night. Day and night. When it's the dark of night, the brightest day, they're there.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Some 66 years is what I figured out. That's what it was. 66 years, 53, 66 years. And I thought, you know, it's like it was 63 years ago. And then they got really excited. They said, we're going to probably have a chance to break a record tomorrow. I said, the record tomorrow is 74. And said, I believe we can break that again tomorrow. Like they're going to do it, you know.
Yeah.
And then he said, that record was set in 1889. I said, so it's been over 100 years since it went 74 degrees on January 2nd. Amen. Praise the Lord. But she hadn't had any heat. They're trying to find the furnace. And she got little heaters and stuff. And I went down to her house yesterday and didn't see much had heat on. You know, just God taking care. Remember Sister Malden telling us about the years she gives money, they was going to put screens on their window because they had flies so bad they saved up the money. God told them to give it to an inspector. I mean, not an inspector, to a missionary. And he needed it. Her husband agreed to give it to them. And they give it to them. And they lived on a creek. And people up on the street was fighting their flies like crazy. And she said, never saw one in her house.
Glory to God.
Never saw one. God takes care of you. He'll take care of you. So,
amen.
You can be the glory of God together. Amen. Amen. Philippians chapter 3, verse 10 through 14. Very familiar scripture, but I just feel like God spoke to me about it this afternoon. That I might know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable to his death, if by any means I might obtain unto the resurrection of the dead. Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after. If that I may apprehend that for which I am apprehended of Christ. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching into those things which are before.
Amen.
I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I just want to preach tonight. God gave me the title before he gave me the message. Just goal set, priorities made. Amen. Amen. Anybody feel like you're there tonight? We don't have to be apprehended. We don't have to be on the top of the mountain. But there, anybody feel like you're there? My goal's set. My priorities are made. Amen. I'm not going to cross the line, and God won't let the devil cross it. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen. 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 Let's pray. Father, we love you tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity of prayer. Just pray so much for the blessings of God, for the angels to watch over us, Lord, to take care of us. I've been there many times, and I know how they're always there, always watching over us, always taking care of us, and keeping us. In Jesus' name we pray. I love you, and I thank you, Lord. Help us if we don't have our goals set, to set them. And if we don't have priorities made, let's make them tonight as we face this new year. In Jesus' name, and the church said amen. Wave at somebody, shake hands, whatever you like to do. Accept, friend. Amen.
Amen.
Show yourself friendly. I hope you know how to make yourself friendly.
Amen.
I hope you're already friendly. Show yourself friendly. Let other people know you got a friend here. Amen. So good to see you in the house of the Lord tonight. Any of those that's not here for this, then we miss you dearly. And we pray that we'll get back soon, like Wednesday night, Friday night at 7 o'clock, and 10 o'clock. We'll have two services. Southland Singers will be here. And also we'll have Brother Chuck Poole preaching in the 10 o'clock service, and Eric preaching in the 7 o'clock service. We're looking forward to that. We pray that you'll be here and be blessed. We're going to have some type of food and refreshments and a break. And even heard one other church said they weren't going to have one. They were going to bring a few people with them. The church not affiliated with us, so I'm proud of that. We welcome all of you. United Church churches come be with us Friday night. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Goal set, priorities made. Amen. I'm telling you that'll keep you going. Amen. If you've got the goal set out there somewhere in front of you, I feel like God has something out there in front of me that makes me hungry to keep going. I told you one time in a message, and I don't have it in my notes, but I told you one time in a message, you know, I've never been to a dog race. I don't really know how it operates. I may have it all wrong, but I've seen them on TV down through the years, you know. And, you know, I did see this, and I thought, how in the world they ever trained them dogs to run like that? And, you know, I found out when I got to looking at it and checking, they keep a holder rabbit out there in front of you. And it goes around and around and around and around and around. And I believe it wear their stuff out. I believe it would just die, because they're going to get that rabbit. And, yeah. and whoever's the fastest is the one that wins the race. And people gamble and make a lot of money on working that dog. Never, I don't know if they ever give them that rabbit or not. Amen. But it's all right. They're trying to hunt it. I want you to know I feel like God's got more than a rabbit out in front of me.
Yes.
God's got something out in front of me that I can keep going when the way gets rough, when the waves roll high, when the clouds hang low. Somebody hear me. I got something to keep me going. I hope you got that tonight. I just feel the presence of God. A little bit warm in here, but that's all right. I feel the presence of God. I know that God is here. I know that he's alive. I know that he's well. And I know that he's watching over us tonight. I give him all that praise. Are you in the fight as a contestant? Are you on the sidelines observing? Amen. I believe it's one or the other. I believe we have to make sure that I'm running for the goal. I'm running for my Lord. I believe the guy up at Mooresboro used to sing that song. I'm running for the Lord, running for my Jesus, running for the Lord. That's what we ought to be doing. We spend so much of our life running from him. We ought to be running for him. Somebody hear me tonight. The contestant in any race pursues for the prize, the gold medal, whereas the observer just watches and watches them just sweat, blood, and tears. They watch them, others receiving the prize, and they spend a lifetime. A lot of times wondering if that could have been me, if that could have been me in that race, I could have done it. While that person at the time and the rest of their life, if things don't change, don't get anything. Somebody hear me. Amen. Don't get lap money in the race for Jesus. Amen. You get money at the finish line. You get the prize, not money, but the prize at the finish line. I believe that's important. Amen. Do you ever think about, just talk to you a little bit tonight, do you ever think about or consider that Christians' walk to be difficult, like it is always an uphill climb? Sometimes I do. I mean, I'm just being honest with you tonight. Sometimes I think, you know, it's been that way for the past couple of months. I just retired in September from public work and full-time ministry now, and I thank the Lord for it. I'm enjoying it. But not one day, I don't think, has been like I planned for it to be when I didn't have nothing to do. And looking back, I don't know how I've had time to work ever. But I did it for 42 years, you know, while I've been here at this church. And God's took care of us. But I can tell you tonight that sometimes it just seems like it's tough. It's tough to keep going, tough to make it. And you know, the Christian walk is like the rest walk. How many times we plan vacations? I'm not going to do nothing next week. I'm just going to sit around and enjoy myself next week and give my body some rest. Nothing wrong with that. Jesus took his disciples aside when they didn't have any leisure and they needed some rest. But before you know it, you blink, the week's gone, and you said, I never did get that rest. Amen. And that's the way we feel like in the army of the Lord. But you know, I'm going to tell you something. There remains a rest day for the saints of God. There comes a time when we'll sit at his
feet. Come on. Amen. Amen.
And we got to look for that, long for that, anticipate that. That's got to be our goal. Amen. My mom and daddy, when I was a little boy, used to sing a song. I have but one goal on earth as I wander down here below, a burden so heavy wherever I go. I'm filled with fear or disaster everywhere I go. But I keep going because I know I have but one goal. Amen. Amen. I thought I messed those words up a little bit. Been a long time to remember something. Amen. But I can tell you tonight that I have one goal. Amen. I above all other goals. I mean, I have some goals. I have a goal to do more for the Lord. I have a goal to get a better husband, better dad, better grandpa, all those things. And God will help us to do those things. But if I fail in those things, I just don't want to fail in my number one goal, to see heaven.
Amen.
My home. I've told you many times how my sweet mother was when my daddy had his little storefront church that she wouldn't say much, but daddy pushed her to say something once in time. Said, you know, her name was Mary Lou. He said, Mary Lou, testify. And she'd get up and do it real quiet, real, and then no shout and jump and running around. But she'd just say how good God was to her and how God had took care of her and give her children, her husband, her family. And she'd always, I never heard but what she said, and I pray that he'll help me to see the end of a Christian life.
Amen.
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 And I'm telling you, that goal will keep you going. She died young, but she saw the end of a Christian life. Amen. And I'm here to tell you tonight, you can too. You can too. Amen. Maybe you're doing okay right now, but does there seem to be a long way to go? Well, that's where I feel like I'm at, you know. At my age, I don't feel like maybe I got a long way to go in a short time to get there. Maybe that's what it is. But I still got a long way to go. I got a long way to go to get closer to God, to get further on my journey. Amen. Sometimes we become weary and tired. And sometimes we even get a little frustrated. Amen. And you say, well, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't. Well, talk to me after service and call me and tell me how you've done it. Amen. I felt that way many times. I just had to keep running. I mean, there's times, you remember what Jim Easton used to say? He said, once in a while I come to church and I have to get my coat and say, you going? And just pull myself on the church. And that's the way we are sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes we just have to get our mind made up and our foot on the rock and we can keep going. God will help us. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Let me preach a little bit. I'm hungry. Preach tonight. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Perhaps you've even been weary, as I said, frustrated. You know, I have. Ever wish God would give you some sort of spiritual zap or something which would immediately transform you into someone who would always say and do the right things with the perfect attitude? I wish I could get that. Amen. I wish I could get that, but I'm not always perfect. I say a lot of bad things. I mean, not cuss words. I can't remember the last time I said a cuss word. You know, it's been years and years and years. And now, you know, I'm saying 40, 50 years. I mean, I may have said a little byword that everybody uses around town, but I try not to say them. I try not to say none of those words because the Bible said that we're responsible to let no corrupt communication come out of our mouth. So I try my best to do that. But when I say bad things, I just say negative things sometimes. I've repeated the words of Tommy's song several times, but just wore out. You know, and I'm not wore out. If I was wore out, I wouldn't be able to move. Amen. I may feel wore out sometimes, but I'm not wore out. If I was, I wasn't able to keep going. And God keeps us going. Amen. I believe that with all my heart. Amen. I would like to have that perfect sap that God could give us, and He does. It's called the anointing. Amen. It's called the anointing of the Holy Ghost. That He can come on you and give you strength when you can't find that. He can get water out of a rock and manna out of heaven. Amen. I just believe He can give you an increase in your strength and energy, and you can keep going. Amen. That sap would be nice, but if it don't come, you just keep on putting one front foot in front of the other. And first thing you know, you'll be there. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I've been on trails before and had a decision to make. You know, maybe I'd be 100 miles from home and a little ways from home. And I'd look at Betty and I'd say, you don't stop me at a room and just drive the rest of the way tomorrow. I said, I'm getting tired. And hardly ever, maybe one time I remember doing that. I talked about it a lot more than I've done it. Somebody hear me.
Amen.
But I'm telling you tonight that I think if I could just get that little bit of strength, if I could just, I could make it. And most of the time, like I said, maybe one time I did stop. But most of the time, you just keep going. And when I get that 100 miles and I'm walking in my house, I say, I'm so glad I didn't stop. Amen. I'm so glad I kept going. I'm so glad I made it the rest of the way.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. God help me do that. He'll help you do that spiritually. Amen. Sometimes maybe you need to stop. You're sleepy. You're tired. I'm not telling you not to do that, but I'm just telling you the walk with God similar to that. We're on a journey, and we're trying to get home, amen? And if we can just make it to the Father's house, we'll be all right. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And I believe that with all my heart, amen. Hallelujah. You ever wonder why some people just seem to have it all together while you're still trying to find all the pieces? Much less put them all together. That's just a misconception of what that is. That's a deception, amen? Because no one has it all together, including the Apostle Paul. As we see here, he said in Philippians chapter 3, we read it to you in our text, and we'll read some more of it in a minute. We'll come back to it. But he said he didn't count himself to be there yet. And you can either just say, well, I'm not ever going to make it. I'll just quit right here. I mean, it's too hard, amen. Yeah. But you got to keep going. You got to keep going. You got to keep going, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. In our Christian life, what we are is on a pilgrimage. We're pilgrims and strangers down here seeking a city to come. Amen. That's what we are. Paul was addressing the people of Philippians who were already saved believers. Amen. But he knew that they were getting discouraged. I preached before, and God completely changed my message because I feel like I was in a room full of people that was discouraged. They didn't need nobody to fuss at them. The Bible said that He has called us to reprove, rebuke, and exhort. If you look those words up, reprove means to tell somebody that they're going down the wrong road, just going down the wrong road and show them the right road. Rebuke means to find somebody going down the wrong road and knows better and tell them you better stop that, you're going to get in trouble.
Amen.
And exhorting them means to encourage them and lift them up. And God does all that for me, so why should I not try to do that for other people? Amen.
Right.
Praise the Lord. Only the devil kicks people when they're down. Somebody hear me. You've got to get up. You've got to get back to the mountain. You've got to get back on fire for God. But don't stop. Please don't stop.
Amen.
Keep going. Press on. The old hymn in the hymn book says it won't be very long. We come into difficulties, struggling with the idea sometimes of Christianity. Whether people get to the point they wonder if they need to make that commitment to Christ. And all these temptations keep coming to people. And finally, their commitment is made to Christ, or even they've walked away. And it's our choice. Amen. We just keep on. Devil, you keep on, and I make you a promise, I won't keep on. Amen.
Amen.
You keep on, I'm not going to stop, I'm not going to give in. Somehow or another, people get confused. They think now their pilgrimage is over, and they have finally reached the city on the hill. But You know, it don't take them long to find out that they're not there yet. Amen.
Man.
Somebody hear me. We're all just like little kids on a trip with our mom and daddy. When we worry our mom and daddy to death and say, are we there yet? We're there yet. Just get on like we're right for a long time. Amen. And I'm a child of God, and I don't like the... I wish this thing was over. We was with the Lord. I wish Jesus would come tonight.
Come on.
Oh, I don't want that. Well, I do. Amen.
Man.
If you're not right with God, you better get right, because there are people around praying for him to come. Somebody say
that. That's right.
They're tired of this world. Amen. They can't feel at home in this world anymore. They're ready to go, fed up with the setup, ready for a lift up to heaven. Amen.
Amen.
And want to go be with God. Somebody hear me.
Amen.
Amen. They're confused to think that they've made it because they're not home. It's the same deception that people have about hell. I've had people to say, hell's right here on earth. Well, it gets tough sometimes. But you keep on believing that, you'll get a rude awakening someday when you end up there where the rich man did when the Bible said he was being in torments and fires not quenched and the worm died not. God would be an unjust, unmerciful God if he did not allow everybody to have the same opportunity to miss that place called hell. Somebody hear me tonight. And he gives it to every one of us. But you're going to have priorities. You're going to have a maid. You're going to have a goal made. You're going to have something set out there for you to get through tonight. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That city on the hill down here is not the way the Bible portrays our Christian life and our walk and our pilgrimage with God. The Bible talks about the Christian life as a pilgrimage, getting through this thing. When you become a Christian, you have only begun the pilgrimage, the trip, the pilgrimage stranger part of your life. The Bible talks about the Christian life being like that. When you become a Christian, you have only begun. Once you become a Christian, then you're called to press on in Christ toward that great day of the Lord, that great goal, becoming like Jesus himself. He said, be ye holy as I'm holy. There may be a struggle in coming to Christ, but no one should consider that when they become a Christian, they've arrived. Somebody hear me today.
Amen.
Because we've only just begun. No, the journey has just begun. Praise the Lord. There is a saying, Christians aren't perfect, just forgiven. That saying might be true, and I'm not saying it's not, because I believe we are forgiven, and I don't believe we're perfect. But it's not an excuse for a sinful lifestyle either.
That's right.
It's not an excuse for you to live like you want to. Paul said it like this many places. God forbid. God forbid that we think we can lift up holy hands in the sanctuary and go outside and live like the devil. We can't do that. Amen?
Amen.
We cannot do that. We can do it as long as God will let us get by, but there won't be any reward. And you've lost sight of your goal. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you don't have your priorities right. Somebody hear me.
Amen.
I believe that's the truth.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We recognize that nobody has arrived, and Christians are not perfect. We are on a journey to become more like Jesus. Christian maturity does not come instantly. Amen. It don't come in a flash. Paul's goal was simply this, to be like Jesus. What a goal. Therefore, I believe that we should be dissatisfied until we have the image of the Son of God conformed in us. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We sing a song like that. Amen. Spirit of God, come into me, refine me, refill me, rethrill me until Jesus Christ is formed in me. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There are two basic statements that every growing Christian will agree with. Number one is we failed in the past. Amen. You say, well, I don't even talk to me. Well, the Bible said we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Amen. And that is, we want to be more like we failed in the past. We've fallen short of God's goal for our life. Number two, that we're dissatisfied with our present spiritual state. That'll get you moving. When you realize that you know that you failed in the past and you're not satisfied with where you are, I'm not repeating the message this morning. You have some similarity. Therefore, you have to decide who you are. Are you in the fight as a contestant? Are you on the sidelines as an observer? You have to find a place. You got to get there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Paul says here that he is by no means a complete Christian, but continues to be challenged and presses on, giving us this vivid picture. You must have priorities, and you must stick with them. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In our text, it said the purpose was that we might know him and the power of his resurrection. I believe it means that we got to see him and feel him. Amen. You know, I'm glad when he saved me, give me something I could feel. And I believe we got to see him and feel him. And the fellowship of his sufferings, you know. Maybe we don't want to do that, but he said if we suffer with him, we'll reign with him. Amen. So there's a prize there, being made conformable unto his death. If by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead. I wrote on top of that there, set the goal. By any means, amen. Hear me? Any means, whatever it takes. Lord, I'll be willing to go. Take the dearest thing to me. Take the most precious thing to me, and I hope you don't. But if you do, I will try my best to keep putting one foot in front of the other and keep walking on. I've just made up my mind. I'm going through. Amen. I'm going to make it with God. And I read Paul's words there, and I thought, nobody. The Bible said there's no temptation taking you other than that is common to man. I'm sure Paul suffered some things I haven't. I've suffered some things that he hasn't. But if 2,000 years ago he could say, my eyes are on the prize. I'm going through no matter what it takes, at any means that I may attain Christ, and I ought to be able to do that today. He said, not like I've already attained. You're already perfect, but I follow after it, that I may apprehend that which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. And then in the last two verses, he said, brother, I count myself not to have apprehended, but this one thing I do. It sounds like a priority, don't it? This one thing I do. I mean, I'll do this or this or this or this. You won't do nothing. Amen. You won't get nowhere. You got to have an idea where you're going, you know? I mean, you know, I'm not very much into sports, but I do know enough about it. When the ball's down here, they're trying to get it to the goal over here. They're trying to get to the other end. And that's all I'm trying to do is get to the end of the way. And they will walk into the way. And I can't wait to get there, Sister Marcia. I just can't wait, right? Brother Donnie, to get there and hear him say, well done, thou good and faithful servant.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Count myself not to have apprehended. But this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth into those things which are before, make the priorities. Set the goal. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
That's what you have to do. Set the goal. And you'll never get there if you don't have priorities. Amen. Tommy told us the other week that God has helped him because he had some health issues, and he had two. In a week, he lost 13 pounds. I'm telling you, he didn't do that on the Krispy Kreme diet. He didn't do that eating little Debbie cakes. Amen. And I can tell you, I've been there. I've been there where I quit eating them. There's a price to pay to get there. Amen. You know, it either goes to... You either waste it or it goes to the waste, it seems like sometimes, you know?
Amen.
Two different words there. But you have to have goals to get those pounds off it. And you're going to have goals to get to heaven, amen?
Amen.
You're going to have priorities, you know? I don't do that anymore, you know? Betty and I had a situation the other day. We thought about it. She was giving some help to Paralyzed Veterans Association. Not a lot of money, but, you know. She gets a little bit, and they come back next week, want a little more and a little more. But they've been sending her prizes, you know? And they sent her a deck of cards the other day. You know how I feel about deck of cards. She said, those cards cost a lot of money. What am I supposed to do with those cards? I said, do what you want to with them. I'm not going to do anything with them. And she said, I said, well, you know, everybody don't have that same conviction we do. Most people got a deck of cards somewhere in their house. And I never had one that I know of that I didn't throw away, amen? And so she came back in her eyes, and I was praying, trying to get closer to God, trying to have a good day, get ready for the day. She said, I'm just going to think and throw these things away. You think that they are? I said, I hit them. You don't get hit them. You don't get them. You know, they were hers, And you individuals. But that's what we have to do. We have to make an individual choice. Somebody said, well, he's preaching against David Carter. No, I'm not. I'm telling you, I don't want nothing to do with it. Amen. I don't want nothing to do with that. And you know, the devil just kind of comes in. I remember when I was a little boy, my daddy would have whooped us if they had dice or cards in their pocket. But you know, they come in through these harmless little games like Monopoly, and I played it many times. I ain't good at it, but I played it. And all those things. And you know, I remember the first time I ever played, I got the dice in my hand. I was going to do this thing. You know, I throw them down, learn how to do the game. Some people don't have a problem with that. But you don't have a problem with a lot of stuff if you don't have a priority. And you don't have no goals. Amen. You have to make up your mind that you're going through.
Amen.
By any means that I can do it. Not looking back at those things behind me. Some people just won't let the past go. But I'm telling you, I let the... You got to get over it, or it'll get over you, amen. You got to get past it, or it'll cause you to fail, amen. So let's say amen.
Amen. That's
right. Amen. Forgetting those things that you're buying. What kind of things are you talking about? The good times, the bad times, amen. You can't live off the good times forever, and you can't die in the bad times. You just have to keep your mind made up to go through, amen. He said, I pressed for it with Mark. If it was easy, you wouldn't have to press. Amen. When you press something, you know. I mean, I went for some therapy the other day for my back. And that guy told me to stand up. Well, anybody knows me, knows I got weak feet. And you just push me. If I know you're coming at me, first thing I'm going to just stabilize myself a little bit. And this therapist told me, he said, hold your shoulders as stiff as you can. So I'm going to push against it. Well, I expected him to start doing like that, you know. Push back. Amen. I'm telling you, I wasn't ready for that. Pressing ain't easy. Somebody hear me. I said, pressing is not an easy thing. And it's certainly not easy physically when you get some age on you. But I can tell you also, it's not easy in the Lord. My mom used to sing a song, it's not an easy road. But many are the rewards along the way.
Amen. Amen.
And I do believe that. But pressing, that, you know, somebody said, oh, it's easy being a Christian. The way of the transgressor's heart. I've heard people say, it's not hard to be a Christian the way of the transgressor's heart. Different kind of hard way. Amen. When you're trying to serve God, and you know, if you think the devil's going to leave you alone, all you had never really tried it. Amen. If you have, he don't leave you alone, is what I'm telling you. He'll do everything he can to get you out of the fight and to get you to give in and throw in the towel.
Amen.
Paul said, I press. It's hard to get past that. I don't see a lot of pressing anymore. I don't see a lot of people pushing and doing everything they can to make it, lest by any means I might attain to the resurrection of the dead. Press toward Mark. For the prize. Amen. Not for Publishers Clearing House. If that ever come, I guess that'd be all right. But and I wouldn't condemn you if you got it. I don't believe in the lottery. I don't play the lottery. Now, just a little sideline there. If you do, it's all right. We're not going to argue about it. But for the prize, there's a prize in serving God. And it waits. I'll have a payday someday. The prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. I want to tell you, as they come back to the music, I'm here to tell you tonight, discouragement within itself is not a sin. But if we don't get rid of it, it may cause us to sin. You stay in discouragement. First thing you know, you have a pity party going on. Won't nobody show up but you. Amen.
Amen.
Jeremiah said, I've been deceived, and I was deceived, and a man of God so faithful to preach 50 years and not ever have one convert. But yet while he was preaching, he got out there just a little bit, and he said, I was deceived. I'm telling you, he wasn't deceived by God. He had it wrong in his mind. He thought, I'll preach this word. Thousands will come in and get saved. And we'll go on to the next group, and the next group, and the next group. And before he got turned around, he's in jail. Amen. Before he turned around, they was against him. They were trying to kill him. And he said, this is not what I bargained for. Different words, but that's what he meant. This is not what I bargained for. I'm telling you, most people that get saved, too many lying prophets out there. If you get saved, everything will be all right. If you get saved, you're stepping into an arena. Well, the devil is out to get you. Amen.
That's right. Amen.
But greater is Jesus in us. And Jesus.
Amen.
And we'll leave on that thought. that he wasn't deceived by God, that he could have been discouraged because he was not ready for what he got. His flesh was failing, amen, but the fire in him kept him going, amen. We got to have something to keep us going, amen. Priorities are good, goals are good, amen. Stand your feet.
Awaits me by God. I'm gonna keep on.
should lie with my mom and dad. What is it going to be like to leave down here and arrive over there? Amen. Praise the Lord. Over there. If you're in more trouble, Father, I'm going to be there. Amen. I hope you are. God has touched this congregation. I know Marcia don't feel well. John's been sick. Different ones. His grandbabies are praying for. And Faith, the one Marcia mentioned. One of them to heal and deliver. We give you all the praise and all the glory to Jesus. Don't forget my God. I'll help you make your mind go.
I'm going to thank the Lord for another great service. Remember the announcements this week. Be back with us Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. We stream live. Remember, special service Friday night, New Year's Eve, be here at 7 o'clock. We'll break somewhere around 9, go to Fellowship Building, we'll come back around 10, be here at midnight, pray the New Year in. No TV this week because it's the first Saturday month. Remember, be back here Sunday. The first Sunday's the first day of the New Year. So if you plan on church being here all year, you got to start with Sunday. If you miss Sunday, you can't say I've been to church all year. So try to be back with us then, be back Sunday night. Bus service will be live on the screen. Anything else? Not Brother Diamond, you would just miss.
Father, we just humble ourselves again, Lord God, as we come to a close tonight, Lord God. It's been good to be in your house today, Lord God. Father, we just thank you, Lord, that you touch lives again today, Lord God. We just love you, Lord God, and just ask you to keep your hand on us now as we go out these doors, Lord God. And we'll just continue to praise you, Lord. Give you the glory in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. Amen.